Today we'll be starting with Unit 1, which is on economic growth models, and I'll begin with Harrod model. Then let me just show you the first reading. You will notice that it is just about 6 pages. It is by Amartya Sen, a part of his text from Growth Economics. We are only doing the first 6 pages. और ये उनके इंट्रोडक्शन का पार्ट है बट इवन इन द इंट्रोडक्शन यू विल फील दैट एवरी लाइन हैज सो मच टू टेल यू सो मच टू ऑफर जो आपको समझ में आएगा व्हेन वी डिस्कस दिस इन डिटेल सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट रीडिंग फ्रॉम यूनिट 1 व्हिच इज ऑन हैरिड मॉडल यू हैव सो फार टॉक्ड अबाउट एग्रीगेट डिमांड and aggregate supply. The intersection of aggregate demand and aggregate supply gives you the equilibrium output and you call this as the national output or national income or GDP and this is your general price level, right? This is something that you have already read. As I said that theories of economic growth will tell you about how this level of y changes over a period of time. So, hum bolte hai that this particular economy is growing at 7%, the other economy is growing at 2%, some other economy is growing at 12%, so on and so forth. We read about all these things jab hum baat karte hai. This is a very important indicator to assess ki कौन सी इकोनॉमी डेवलप्ड है कौन सी इकोनॉमी अंडर डेवलप्ड है कौन सी इकोनॉमी फास्टेस्ट ग्रोइंग इकोनॉमी है सो ऑन एंड सो फोर्थ So we are specifically going to talk about this percentage change in output. So this percentage change in Y is nothing but economic growth. And इस यूनिट में हम बात करेंगे कि कौन सी ऐसी थ्योरीज हैं जो हमें एक्सप्लेन करती हैं इस ग्रोथ प्रोसेस के बारे में हमें समझाती हैं कि क्या एग्जैक्टली इस ग्रोथ प्रोसेस में होता है कौन से फैक्टर्स हैं जिसकी वजह से ये परसेंटेज चेंज इफेक्ट होता है और क्या ये ग्रोथ थ्योरी क्या ये डिफरेंट थ्योरीज एक्चुअली में रियल लाइफ से मैच करती हैं या नहीं करती हैं इनके क्या ड्रॉबैक्स हैं और अगर इफ व्हाई आर देयर सो मेनी ग्रोथ थ्योरीज व्हाई कांट वी हैव वन सिंगल थ्योरी जो इस पूरे ग्रोथ प्रोसेस को एक्सप्लेन करे दीज आर द डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ क्वेश्चंस दैट वी विल हैंडल द फर्स्ट मॉडल दैट वी आर डूइंग इज कॉल्ड एज द हैरिड मॉडल हैरिड मॉडल क्यों है क्योंकि जिसने इस मॉडल को इंट्रोड्यूस करा था वो उस इकोनॉमिस्ट का नाम हैरिड था एंड ही इंट्रोड्यूस्ड हिज फुल नेम इज रॉय हैरिड ही इंट्रोड्यूस्ड दिस मॉडल इन 1939 इफ यू रिमेंबर दिस वॉज द टाइम जब एक बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट एपिसोड हुआ था इकोनॉमी में वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमी में विच वाज कॉल्ड एज द ग्रेट डिप्रेशन दिस वाज द टाइम 1930s वाज द टाइम जब इकोनॉमीज में ग्रेट डिप्रेशन का फेज ऑब्जर्व करा जा रहा था नॉट जस्ट वन सिंगल इकोनॉमी अ लॉट ऑफ इकोनॉमीज वर अफेक्टेड बाय दिस एपिसोड ऑफ ग्रेट डिप्रेशन जहां जिस टाइम पे अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट और इन्फ्लेशन ये सारी चीजें बहुत मेजरली इफेक्ट कर रही थी सारी इकोनॉमीज को एंड एट दिस पर्टिकुलर टाइम ग्रोथ वॉज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन फॉर डिफरेंट इकोनॉमीज इट वॉज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन कि बिफोर दिस टाइम बिफोर 1930s इकोनॉमिकली थिंग्स वर क्वाइट नॉर्मल थिंग्स वर क्वाइट प्लेसेड इन द वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमिक स्फेयर सब लोग क्लासिकल थॉट को बिलीव करते थे एवरीबडी बिलीव्ड कि अगर इकोनॉमी में कोई भी इश्यूज आते हैं जैसे अगर किसी इकोनॉमी में अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट हो रही है या किसी इकोनॉमी में इन्फ्लेशन हो रहा है तो ये सारी जो चीजें हैं दीज विल ओनली हैपन फॉर अ वेरी शॉर्ट टाइम एंड इन द लॉन्ग रन एवरीथिंग विल फिक्स इटसेल्फ सो बिफोर दिस टाइम एवरीबडी बिलीव्ड दैट मार्केट्स आर सेल्फ करेक्टिंग एंड वी डोंट रियली नीड टू वरी अबाउट एनीथिंग But after this episode, after this long episode of Great Depression, जब कुछ भी नहीं हो रहा था everybody believed कि markets अपने आप correct करेंगे लेकिन इतना time सारी economies ने wait करा markets अपने आप को correct नहीं कर रहे थे and that is when newer theories had come into picture which is that of Keynes about government intervention. People started talking about how markets are not self-correcting and how governments can play a role to change the scenario or to fix the issues, फिक्स द इकोनॉमिक इश्यूज जो फेस कर रही थी इकोनॉमीज. एंड दैट इज व्हेन द कॉन्वर्सेशन अबाउट इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ स्टार्टेड हैपनिंग. इससे पहले दिस वॉज नॉट अ वेरी मेजर सब्जेक्ट इन इकोनॉमिक्स. एज एकेडमिक्स ऑल्सो जो ये सब्जेक्ट है डेवलपमेंट इकोनॉमिक्स और ग्रोथ थ्योरी और इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ, ये सारे जो टॉपिक्स हैं इकोनॉमिक्स में, ये इस एपिसोड के बाद से ज्यादा प्रोमिनेंट हुए. इससे पहले देयर वाज नॉट मच डिस्कशन दैट वाज हैपनिंग ऑन दीज टॉपिक्स. सो दैट इज व्हेन रॉय हैरड केम अप विद एन आइडिया एंड केम अप विद थ्योरी. एंड ही ट्राइड टू एक्सप्लेन दैट कौन से ऐसे फैक्टर्स हैं जिनकी वजह से इस आउटपुट को हम इंक्रीज कर सकते हैं या वी कैन मेंटेन अ पर्टिकुलर ग्रोथ रेट और अ सस्टेनेबल ग्रोथ रेट इन दिस लेवल ऑफ नेशनल आउटपुट. बिकॉज दैट वाज द मेन फैक्टर जो नहीं ग्रो कर पा रहा था, अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट था, और अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट इसीलिए था बिकॉज आउटपुट वॉज सप्रेस्ड. सो पीपल वॉन्टेड टू नो, गवर्नमेंट्स वॉन्टेड टू नो, इकोनॉमिस्ट वॉन्टेड टू नो, पॉलिसी मेकर्स वॉन्टेड टू नो कि हम इस वाई को कैसे बूस्ट कर सकते हैं. एंड दैट इज व्हेन हैरड had introduced his model in 1939. Now, what exactly is his model? In this reading, जो हम reading refer कर रहे हैं, इस reading में actually Harrod model क्या होता है, Harrod model का exact you know equation का derivation और exact model क्या होता है, ये इतना detail में नहीं बताया. What we are dealing with is the instability problem of the Harrod model, which I will eventually come to. But before coming to that, मैं आपको definitely एक brief idea यहाँ पे present कर रही हूँ Harrod model का. Now, Harrod का ये कहना था कि only attain growth by making some sacrifices. वो कर सकते हैं as economies, but we can only do that by sacrificing. और इस sacrifice के लिए economics में एक term है जो हम सब जानते हैं, विच इज सेविंग्स. सो हैरड सेड दैट इट इज ओनली बाय सैक्रिफाइसिंग कंजम्पशन और इन अदर वर्ड्स बाय सेविंग दैट वी कैन अटेन इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ. सो द वेरी बेसिक आइडिया ऑफ हैरड वॉज दैट सपोज यू आर अर्निंग अ पर्टिकुलर लेवल ऑफ इनकम एज एन इकोनॉमी. नाउ अगर आपके पास बेसिकली दो आउटलेट्स होते हैं, आपकी इनकम या तो कंजम्पशन में जाती है या फिर सेविंग्स में जाती है. यू नो दिस इक्वेशन y इज इक्वल टू c प्लस s, राइट. नाउ हैरड का बहुत ही बेसिक फंडामेंटल आइडिया था कि अगर आपकी पूरी इनकम जो है कंजम्पशन में जाएगी, देन यू कैन नेवर ग्रो एज एन इकोनॉमी. इट इज ओनली थ्रू सैक्रिफाइसिंग कंजम्पशन और बाय सेविंग अ पार्ट ऑफ योर इनकम दैट यू कैन ग्रो. And how does that channel actually operate? We say that suppose if I talk about a very simple two sector model, जहाँ पे households हैं और firms हैं, ठीक है. I'm not talking about government and the rest of the world. I'm just talking about a simple two sector model. And I'm saying that households can consume and firms can also consume. Households basically consume consumer goods and firms would consume capital goods. Consumer goods होते हैं जिनका purpose सिर्फ consumption का होता है, ठीक है. You don't use these goods in any other form except consumption. Capital goods वो goods होते हैं जिनको आप किन्हीं और दूसरे goods को बनाने के लिए use करते हो. So suppose I talk about a particular machine, right? This is a capital good. Why? Because this could be called as a consumer good also, but depending on the final use of this good, this could be classified as a consumer good or a capital good. So this machine, let's say this is some sewing machine, ठीक है, कोई सिलाई मशीन है जिससे आप कपड़े बना सकते हो. Now this could be a consumer good if I am keeping this sewing machine in my house. But suppose I have a factory, I have a garment factory, and if I am purchasing this sewing machine in my garment factory for my garment factory, then this will be called as a capital good. So the basic difference between capital and consumer good is that consumer good is only used for consumption and not used for producing any other commodity. Capital goods are goods which could be used for producing any other commodity. So I am saying that firms tend to consume capital goods and households tend to consume consumer goods. Households also have another outlet. So households have a certain level of income, and I'm telling you the routes जो households follow कर सकते हैं इस income को spend करने के लिए. दूसरा route है households के पास savings का. Households can save a part of their income. And when households save a part of their income, where does this go? These savings through some intermediaries. And what could be these intermediaries? Financial institutions. Let's just take a very simple example of a bank. So these savings in this two-sector model will ultimately reach the firms. So save kahan pe karenge households? Maybe they'll go to the bank and they'll open an account and they'll keep the money with the bank, expecting that the bank will give them some returns so that they can grow, right? They can grow, they can increase their income. Banks would further lend this money to these firms as a form of investment. Firms are further going to use this money, jo yahan se mil rahi hai. These households can also directly save with the firms. Okay, so there could be different channels in which this saving could reach the firms. You know, jab aap baat karte ho shares ki. That could be the direct route where the households are shareholders of the firms, where they are supplying some capital to the firms. So the channel doesn't really matter. What matters is that this saving is ultimately reaching the firms in the form of investment. Now the firms will use this investment to maybe purchase more capital goods. They will invest in their production process. जो भी प्रोडक्शन प्रोसेस फॉर्म्स कर रहे हैं उसमें वो इन्वेस्ट करेंगे, बिकॉज नाउ दे हैव एन एक्स्ट्रा पूल ऑफ मनी. दे विल मे बी गेट मोर मशीन्स, दे मे बी दे टेक अ न्यू लैंड वेयर दे यू नो प्लांट अ न्यू फैक्ट्री एंड द प्रोडक्शन विल इंक्रीज, मीनिंग द आउटपुट विल इंक्रीज. व्हेन द आउटपुट इंक्रीजेस द डिमांड विल ऑल्सो इंक्रीज फॉर दिस आउटपुट. वाई? Because when this output is increasing, then the firms also create some income. यहाँ पे output increase हो रहा है and simultaneously income भी create हो रही है in the form of wages. So the firms, households will supply labor to the firms. Households can also supply land to the firms. Labor could be supplied. Different factors of production would be supplied from households, and in return for these factors of production, firms will pay them some money. And this money that is being paid by the firms is income that is being created by the households. Ye jo income hai, again the story comes back to this level of why. So you will notice that it is only because consumers or households are saving that this entire channel of income creation is generated. अगर हाउसहोल्ड सोचते हैं कि आज हम सेव नहीं करेंगे, वी विल ओनली कंज्यूम, देन डू यू थिंक दिस चैनल कैन प्रोसीड? नो. सो हैरोल्ड्स आइडिया वॉज वेरी सिंपल. ही सेड दैट इट इज ओनली व्हेन यू सेव, इट इज ओनली व्हेन यू सैक्रिफाइस कंजम्पशन इन द प्रेजेंट टाइम पीरियड दैट यू कैन बिल्ड ऑन एक्सपैंडिंग योर इनकम लेवल. सो व्हेन हाउसहोल्ड सेव, more investment goes to the firms, firms invest more, and then they create more output. This output generates income for the households, and this income will create demand for these commodities, and it will also create savings which further goes to the firms in the form of investment. So ye jo simple cycle chal rahi hai, isko Harrod ne study kara, aur Harrod ne bola that this is the model that I have, a very simple model that investment or capital plays a key role in the growth process. So he only talked about capital and the role of capital in the economic growth process that Harrod had when he was trying to create his model, and he gave the answers of these three questions. First is possibility of steady growth. And he said that in a model of fixed capital output ratio and savings output ratio, I'll just explain what these terms mean. In the presence of fixed capital output ratio and savings output ratio, he said that steady growth could be achieved at this rate. Harrod said that this steady growth could be achieved at this level, which is small s by c, where small s refers to savings output ratio and c refers to the capital output ratio. Now, what do we mean by capital output ratio and savings output ratio? Let's look at that. So, capital output ratio is nothing but total capital divided by total output. But iska interpretation kya hai? We are saying that to produce one unit of output, how much amount of capital is needed? That is given by this capital output ratio. So suppose you say that capital output ratio is higher. It means higher the capital needed to produce one unit of output will indicate a less productive production process. Idea of capital output ratio is that how much capital do you need to produce one unit of output? And if you have a higher capital output ratio, it means that to produce one unit of output, you need higher capital, which tells you that the production process is less productive. So a higher capital output ratio is actually not good for an economy's production process. The productivity is lesser. If capital output ratio is lesser, that means that you require lesser capital to produce a unit of output and hence high productivity. Yeah. Savings output ratio, on the other hand, is the total amount of savings divided by the total amount of output, which is basically the proportion of the income that goes into savings. So again, if this is higher, if savings is higher, by the basic logic of Harrod model, this will be more. This should promote more growth, because that is what the Harrod model is saying, that if there are higher savings in the economy, then that will lead to more growth, more income creation. And hence, if this ratio is higher, if you are using a higher percentage of your income goes to savings, then that will promote more growth. If it is lesser, then that will indicate lesser growth. So, two things are at play. One is the capital output ratio, which is the amount of capital needed to produce a unit of output. If you require a higher amount of capital, then the production process is less productive. You are wasting a lot of capital on producing one unit of output. And if capital output ratio is lesser, then that depicts higher productivity and more growth. So higher productivity, more growth. Harrod basically said that these two factors will lead to growth process, and depending on what is the savings rate in the economy and what is the capital output ratio, we can determine the level of growth rate for an economy. So he said that the growth rate in the Harrod model could be represented by this ratio S by C, where S refers to the savings rate or the savings output ratio, and C refers to the capital output ratio. The second question is that he pointed out is the stability of this steady growth. Whether once you reach this level of growth rate, is that process stable or not? And that is the element that we are basically discussing in this reading, which is the instability of Harrod model. हमने बोला था that capital plays a key role in the economic growth process according to Harrod. Harrod said that savings is a very important factor. And why savings is an important factor? क्योंकि savings will ultimately lead to investment. And investment is nothing but a change in capital. Harrod basically placed a major onus of the growth process on this investment. Now, when we talk about investment, how do we understand investment is important? One way of understanding investment is through a classical approach, which is we believe, and this could be mostly applicable for planned economies, right? Economies which are planned. Maybe this is true, but this may not always be true. So what do we say when we talk about classical idea of investment is that planned savings are equal to investment. Remember, you would have read about this in some other macro course in the previous semesters, where you talked about ex ante and ex post. And classical model tends to believe that actual investment in the economy would be equal to planned savings. So, jitna bhi aapne plan kara hai, whatever is your ex ante will be equal to the ex post. This kind of understanding of investment may be true, may hold true for economies which are planned economies, but this is not always true. And a lot of times, investment works through the channel of accelerator model. The accelerator model or the accelerator idea of investment believes on the expectation of future. Harrod introduced this kind of investment in his model because he wanted his model to be more applicable to reality. Based on the expectation of future effective demand, investments will be created in the present. So suppose you expect the future effective demand to be at a certain level, let's say level Y. Yeah, this is your expectation of the effective demand in, say, time period T plus 1. Your current investment, which is in time period T, will be some factor of this. That is what the accelerator model is, that you expect the future demand to be something. Investors or firms will believe that the future effective demand will be at so and so level, and keeping that in mind, keeping that expected income or expected effective demand in mind, you will invest the appropriate amount in the present so that you can meet this effective demand. So suppose you expect ki agle saal demand hone wali hai 100, aur aapki jo current investment hai, that only allows you to produce 80 units of this commodity Y, of some commodity X, then you might want to invest 20 more to your current production process. This is the idea of the kind of investment that Harrod had introduced in his model. That based on the expectation of the future, what is the investment that you need to make today? That is the kind of investment that Harrod had planted in his model. And based on this idea, he has two sub-questions. One is, when will the investor's expectation be realized? So investors will decide to invest a certain amount based on the expectation of the future. So pehla question Harrod ka hai ki kab ye expectation meet hoengi. Dusra question hai ki agar ye expectation meet nahi hongi to kya hoga? What will happen if expectations are not realized? And we are primarily going to deal with these two questions in the following part of the reading. Now, let's look at some equations. Okay, so given the capital ratio, capital output ratio C, which is total capital divided by total output, we say that investment, what is investment? Investment is nothing but change in capital, right? Agar abhi current capital stock hai, let's say X units, or next year capital stock ho jayega X plus delta X, then this is nothing but the investment. Investment is nothing but change in capital, right? The Harrod model says that investment in period T, in time period T, equals C times the expected additional flow of output. C times the expected additional flow of output. And why can we say that? Is because if C is equal to total capital by total output, then I can say that capital is nothing but C into Y. And then I can say that if investment is delta K, then delta K, I can estimate delta K from here. We are assuming this to be constant. Remember when I talked about the first point, I said that these are fixed. In the model of fixed capital output ratio and savings output ratio, we are assuming these to be exogenous. We are saying ki koi bhi parameter jo hum apne model mein estimate kar rahe hain, such as output, that doesn't guide the these ratios, that doesn't affect these ratios. So we are assuming in the Harrod model that the capital output ratio or the savings ratio, savings output ratio is fixed, is constant. So change in capital will be entirely because of change in output. So we say that delta K will be equal to C times delta Y, right? And delta K is nothing but investment. So I can say that investment is nothing but C into delta Y. And this is the additional flow of output. Delta Y is the additional flow of output, which will happen from the previous time period. Now, we just talked about the expectation of the future output. Let's say that expected output in the future is assumed to be XT. Delta Y will basically be the change in output. I am saying that this is equal to XT minus YT minus 1. जो अभी मैंने बोला कि इन्वेस्टमेंट जो है हैरड मॉडल में एक्सिलरेटर टाइप की होती है, जिसमें करंट इन्वेस्टमेंट इज बेस्ड ऑन द आउटपुट दैट द इन्वेस्टर एक्सपेक्ट्स टू बी देयर इन द फ्यूचर. तो मैं उसी चीज को न्यूमेरिकली यहां पे मैं लिख रही हूँ. दैट इज द फर्स्ट इक्वेशन दैट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर अस फॉर द फ्यूचर कॉन्सेप्ट्स, विच इज दैट इन्वेस्टमेंट इज इक्वल टू कैपिटल आउटपुट रेशियो इन टू XT minus YT minus 1, where XT refers to expected output. This is not reality, okay? मतलब ये ध्यान में रखना है कि ये actual output नहीं है. अभी हम इसको actual output नहीं मान रहे हैं. अभी हम बोल रहे हैं that this is the expected output for time period T. And this is the actual output of time period T minus 1. If the actual output in time period T minus 1 was this, and I expect, investors expect the output in time period T to be this, this will be the change in output. This is the extra effective demand jo investors expect kar rahe hain future ke liye. And based on this extra effective demand, investors are going to decide ki kitna investment karna hai. Aur wo kitna hoga? C times this additional flow of output. Because C tells you ki एक आउटपुट को प्रोड्यूस करने के लिए कितना कैपिटल लगेगा. तो अगर इतना टोटल आउटपुट है जो चेंज हो रहा है, तो उसको जब आप सी से मल्टीप्लाई करोगे, कैपिटल आउटपुट रेशियो से मल्टीप्लाई करोगे, तो आपको पता लगेगा कि कितना एक्स्ट्रा कैपिटल आपको नीडेड है टू बी एबल टू मीट दिस एक्स्ट्रा इफेक्टिव डिमांड. सो इफ आई एम डिसाइडिंग माई इन्वेस्टमेंट फॉर टाइम पीरियड टी, मैं ये जानना चाहूंगी कि अभी T minus 1 में कितना आउटपुट था. दैट इज वाई टी माइनस 1. दिस इज द एक्चुअल आउटपुट. लेट्स से दिस इज 100, ठीक है. और मैं ये जानना चाहूंगी कि T टाइम पीरियड में मैं कितना आउटपुट एक्सपेक्ट करती हूँ, कितना डिमांड एक्सपेक्ट करती हूँ. दैट इज लेट्स से 120. नाउ दिस इज माय एक्सपेक्टेशन. व्हेन आई रीच टाइम पीरियड T, मे बी दिस इज greater than 120, maybe this is less than 120, that will be the actual output in time period T, which will be represented by YT. YT refers to the actual output that you experience in time period T, and XT refers to your expectation. So this XT refers to the expected output, and hence the difference between the expected output in time period T and the actual output in time period T minus 1 is this delta Y, is the additional flow of output. The second here is, which is something that you have read previously, ki agar investment change hoti hai, that is the process of multiplier. And that is what the Harrod model assumed, ki income will change by the process of multiplier. So, actual output in time period T will be determined by this equation, which is the equation of multiplier. जिसका क्या मतलब है कि अगर investment change होती है by a small amount, if it changes by delta I, this will lead to change in output. this change in output will further lead to change in consumption, because output change hoga to consumption change hoga. This change in consumption will further lead to change in investment. So the final increase in investment is not by the same amount. जितना आय change हो रहा है, change in capital. जितना capital change हो रहा है, the change in output will be a multiplier of that change in capital. ये याद होगा आपको, ऐसा कुछ आपने पढ़ा था, multiplier. So this small s is nothing but MPS. And I can say that MPS and MPC को जब मैं ऐड करूंगी तो मुझे 1 मिलेगा. सो 1 माइनस एमपीसी को मैं एमपीएस से रिप्लेस करती हूँ. मार्जिनल प्रोपेंसिटी टू कंज्यूम क्या होता है, सी बाय वाई, एंड मार्जिनल प्रोपेंसिटी टू सेव इज एस बाय वाई, एंड एस बाय वाई इज व्हाट इज स्मॉल एस हियर. सो आई कैन से दैट दिस इज इक्वल टू 1, एंड हेंस आई कैन से दैट 1 माइनस सी बाय वाई इज इक्वल टू एस बाय वाई. सो 1 अपॉन 1 माइनस एमपीसी को मैं 1 अपॉन स्मॉल एस भी लिख सकती हूँ. So these are the basic two equations that you need to know to understand the flow of action in the Harrod model. Jo Harrod ne apne dimag mein socha tha ki this is how things will operate in an economy, and based on these flow of actions in an economy, he gave his theory, he gave his growth rate, and then he raised certain questions about it. So let me just quickly give you a recap of the flow of actions so that it is all clear to all of you. We say that we want to plan for time period T. ठीक है, and हमने बोला है Harrod model is entirely dependent on savings and investment. जितना save होगा उतना ज्यादा investment होगा, उतना ज्यादा output creation होगा. That is the basic idea of Harrod model. Now in time period T, Harrod model in time period T, investors have a certain expectation for the output in time period T. So they are planning for time period T, but they are actually in time period T minus 1. ठीक है, investors ये जो planning कर रहे हैं T minus 1 time period में कर रहे हैं, but they are planning for the next time period, which is time period T. Now in time period T minus 1, investors have a certain expected output in their head कि this is the level of output जो अगले साल होने वाला है, and in time period T minus 1 they know कि y t minus 1 क्या है, which is actual output क्या है time period t minus 1 में, ये investors को पता है. अगले साल क्या output होने वाला है, they have built an expectation which is xt. So according to the investors in time period t minus 1, the additional flow of output will be xt minus yt minus 1. This is according to the investors. ठीक है, now because investors को लग रहा है कि ये additional output create होगा, they will plan their investment according to this additional flow of output. So they say ki hum time period T minus 1 mein, for the next time period, we will invest C into this additional flow. So that is the first equation, C into XT minus YT minus 1. Itna investment create kar diya. Now that this investment has been created by the investors, the actual output will be 1 upon s into this investment created by the investors in the first step. Harrod is saying that the investment is that of accelerator type. That is the first assumption, first understanding of Harrod of the economic world. Unko lagta hai ki economics mein jo bhi ye variables hai wo is tarike se kaam kar rahe hain, that is something jo us time pe economic situations ke according unka thought tha, right? So thoughts have also progressed with what they see around themselves. Economists or policy makers also change their thoughts with what they see around us. So us type pe they felt that investment is of accelerator type, and that's what's happening here. Based on the expectation of the future, investors will create certain investment, and once this investment has been established, the change in output or the actual output will be guided by this multiplier process. So the actual output, remember now on the in the second equation on the left hand side, you don't have xt, you have yt. So yt will be equal to 1 by s into investment. I hope things are clear till this step. Ye basic do jo steps humne kare hain, which is what Harrod had imagined the economy to be at that point, step, which is that from these two equations 1 and 2, I can actually calculate yt by xt. I am basically just dividing equation 2 by equation 1. So yt is what? 1 by s it, or I can say this is 1 by s, and I also have xt, right? So I can get yt by xt, ratio of the actual output to the expected output, which will be equal to xt minus yt minus 1, and I also have a c here. So this is the equation that I get. This is the third equation, which is the ratio of the actual output to the expected output. Now, if I look at it carefully, then I can convert this equation into a more meaningful equation by saying that yt by xt is equal to c by s into g hat t. If you look at this, xt minus yt minus 1 upon xt, can I replace it with growth rate? I am saying that this is the growth rate, the expected growth rate. Because why? Why expected growth rate? Because I have xt. So we are taking the growth as a proportion of xt. You can have it in two forms. You can also have it in this form, xt minus yt minus 1 by yt minus 1. That's also a growth rate. So you can either write it, growth rates could either be written in this form or this form. This one is specifically as a proportion of the future output, which is xt. But this is expected growth rate. Q, because yahan pe hum yt nahi put kar rahe, xt put kar rahe. So that's why you have a hat here. And I'm saying that this is an expected growth rate. Now, remember the second second point made by Harrod had two sub questions. The first question was, when will the investor's expectation be met? Now we are at a point where we can answer this question. Answer this first question. So, kis time, at what particular condition will xt be equal to yt? Is the question raised by Harrod that when will the investor's expectation be met means that investors are expecting xt and actual output is yt. At what point will the two be equal to each other? I can write from this equation, I can say that xt will be equal to yt when this expected growth rate is equal to s by c. In Harrod's language, or in his paper, he has called this as warranted rate of growth. Okay, so when expected output is equal to actual output, this condition from this equation, this condition will hold true only when gt hat is equal to s by c. To the first question is already established that investor's expectation will be met when the growth rate will be equal to s by c. Now, let's look at the second question, second part, which is, what happens if the expectation is not met? Zaruri to nahi hai ki investors hamesha correctly expect karenge. I mean, it would be nice if investors reach this expected rate, and then the equilibrium will be established because expected output will be exactly equal to actual output. But this may not always hold true. It is not always true that investors will have complete information that they can forecast the savings rate or the capital output ratio, or they can determine that this is the growth rate at which the output is growing. So what if the expected growth rate is something else than S by C? Let's try and build a relationship between GT and GT hat. GT hat is the expected or the warranted rate of growth, and GT is the actual rate of growth. Actual rate of growth ko main kaise likh sakti hu? We are taking this with respect to YT, because that is how we have defined warranted rate of growth. So GT will be this value. Now let's try and make some use our mathematical skills to sort of establish some relationship between GT and GT hat. Now, we know that GT hat is equal to XT minus YT minus 1 upon YT, sorry, XT I am making some manipulations, subtracting one from both sides. Subtracting from one, not one. So subtracting from one both sides, I will have 1 minus gt hat is equal to, right? Then in the next step, I am dividing by gt hat both sides. And on the right side, I will have, let's play. Okay, now what I'm doing is I'm multiplying s by c both sides. So I have 1 minus, okay. And from the definition of s by c, which I had written out in this step, I can say that s by c, let me call this equation 4. Okay? So from this equation, I can say that s by c is equal to xt by yt into gt hat. I am just putting this entire term, the right side here. So in this next step, left term stays the same. The right term, I'm just trying to simplify this. S by C ke jagah pe main ye pura substitute kar rahi hun. This is XT by YT into GT hat. GT hat will get cancelled. XT and XT will also get cancelled. So on the right side, I am left with YT minus 1 by YT. Now I can convert this into GT. I have YT minus 1 by YT and I know that GT is equal to what? YT minus YT minus 1 by YT. So what I can do is I can just subtract from 1 both sides and I will get my result. I will be left with 1 minus GT hat by GT hat into S by C is equal to, right? Right side pe mere paas kya hai? YT minus 1 upon YT. Maine dono side 1 se subtract kara hai. So 1 minus this entire term maine yahan pe likh diya hai. And when I subtract YT minus 1, so the final result that I have is 1 minus bracket 1 minus GT prime by GT prime into S by C is equal to GT. This is the relationship that I wanted to establish, which is the relationship between expected growth rate or warranted growth rate and actual. This is the final relationship that we have between warranted and actual growth rate as per Harrod's model.